Morning, everyone. This is day 29 of 30 Days Apart with Anya, and today I'm going to be going to my friend George's house to paint the chapel. No, the castle, Edinburgh Castle. But I thought I want to still keep my daily practice of just drawing for myself in the morning going, so I'm just doing this little drawing of a flower. Kind of inspired, I think it might have been by Elise's beautiful drawing of an orchid. There's loads of lovely drawings of flowers recently on the Facebook group page that have inspired me. And I'm inspired too by this cyclamen that died when I was in Ireland and came back to life. So in gratitude to this flower for blooming again, I'm going to paint that one today. No, I'm going to draw it. Okay, so hopefully you'll be able to see. And oh yeah, I left, I'm assuming I left the microphone in the studio, because I couldn't find it today again. So I'm just going to hope for the best. At least there's no wind here, and I'm close enough to the camera that hopefully you'll be able to see. Isn't that just a lovely thing, opening this beautiful book that Susan made for me? Okay. I love the whole ritual of that. Oh, there's my ring. Okay. Here we are, I think this way. It seems to me that it's wider than it is high, the flower, from where I'm looking. I'm just going to begin. I've gotten used to speaking quietly because I had the microphone. And now I feel like I need to project my voice a bit more. Which kind of doesn't really go with the studied act of observing. Somebody said that drawing is really a concentrated exercise in seeing. And I guess you don't really want to be distracted by having to shout. But this level is good for me, and I hope you can hear me and see what I'm up to. Yeah. Okay. This one where each petal overlaps the next, and by how much. I'm also noticing the shape of the space between the petals. I've got a cat on either side of me this morning. It's quite nice. Sometimes tolerate each other in the same couch. And when I came down here this morning, the two of them were asleep on the couch. So I think I will post the castle painting as well, of course. But before I leave today, it would be good to have ticked this box, and I didn't have a video. I had decided I was gonna wait until I did the castle video and then find somewhere to post it in Edinburgh, like a cafe or something. But actually, and that feels a bit too much like pressure. So when I looked at this flower this morning and felt inspired to draw it, I thought, that's good enough for today now. And then maybe your final day tomorrow can be Edinburgh Castle. Or whatever castle. Or whatever buildings that are significant or in your area that you would like to draw. Whatever you like, really. I thought too about public sculptures, like monuments and things, would have been quite a nice subject as well. And my other idea was side profile portrait. I need to figure out what to do about the group as well. Group page, whether I can keep that open. has been a really lovely community. Well, of course, I was going to go back to Cookenzie Harbour too, wasn't I? I never went back there. I can let you know on the group page if I am going back there another time. You can join me. So now that I've found the general shape of everything here, I don't actually have a rubber, so I'm just going to allow the lines, finding lines to remain. It just needs to extend a little more that way. Because when I looked at the width of it, it read to me as being a bit wider than I've got it. So I'm extending this petal over to the left a little bit farther. And also that one. Yeah, and this corner too. It feels kind of exciting to me to leave the lines underneath. Don't know how it is, but put it like that. Everything moves a bit to the left there. Okay. Off. 8 minutes are up. No, you're still crying. I have no idea how much time is left there. So this is the stem coming in. I quite like this little plateau in a sickening flower where it's like it's a little flat edge from which everything can be can extend from. Okay. And then the step comes in strangely high up there. It's darker where it enters the flower, it's lighter as it comes out the way. Now I want to half close my eyes so that I can see the darks and lights that make up the darks and lights that explain the structure of the petals and how they extend into the light in places.